Hey, this is Overpass Insights. My name is Eric and I make apps. Today, let's ask the question, are most software developers just terrible? So, a few years ago, I did a video about Indian app developers. See, one of the things in my business and in my day-to-day life is I hear a lot of things about developers from India. So, I'll be talking to clients and they'll say, oh, you're going to give this to India? I heard that Indian developers aren't very good. Or I'll be talking to other developers saying, and they'll say something like, well, there's your problem, Eric. You gave it to an Indian team. You should have given it to a team from Bulgaria or Russia or America or whatever. And honestly, my response has always been, there are some really, really good developers in India. I work with some excellent developers in India, and I work with a whole lot of really, really bad ones, right? And it's the same everywhere. My personal and my professional belief is you could be a good software developer no matter where you come from, but you have to put in the work, and you have to be the kind of person who digs and digs and is always improving, because the industry is always changing. Anyway, on that video, I got a new comment on that video just this morning, which is really, really good, and I wanted to share it with you. It's from B199er. It's a bit long, but it's really in-depth, and I wanted to get your guys' opinion on this. So B199er says, it's a numbers game. To be brutally honest, 90% of developers suck. 9% can be used to develop competitive software, but only 1% are decent, and as in they can really think, have a sense of direction, design, architect, and create core engines / frameworks for the worker bees, the other 99 to work on. Usually this 1% are the John Carmacks, the game developers, the indie game developers, true programmers who have a passion for the art, aka back bedroom programmers in the 80s. Westerners and Russians usually go into programming for passion rather than being drawn into the industry for money. In contrast, India's large volume of programmers are largely cranked out through institutions like college/university/ coding schools. This simply cannot create the same caliber. After working in the industry for a decade or so, some will develop skills to move into that 1% rank. However, the vast majority will never sit in a software team doing anything other than donkey work. It's the 90-10 rule. 10% of coders in a team do 90% of the create a framework, core engine, come up with architectural design, build standalone product. The other 90% do the other 10%. Add a button here, add a feature here, fix a bug there. That's a general problem in software teams all over the world. I've read that a quality of Indians is that they're comfortable working with ad hoc systems, a tangled mess of wires. I think this could be a blessing and a curse. Most Western programmers I talk to always bitch about crappy code designs to the point where the only way that bitching will stop the code gets refactored to something more elegant. In this regard, I suspect that Indians culturally are less unnerved about such mess. So they're more inclined to just add more code, increasing in complexity. And it goes on and on and on. And it says, that said, India is a big country and has a large number of programmers. 1% of that large number is quite an impact. So I wouldn't say that India is notable for having good programmers. They're known for having a large number of programmers, especially in the context of English-speaking West, in contrast to a lot of China's programmers developed for Chinese companies for the Western market. The best route to develop your own programming skills, especially architecture and design, is by developing your own hobby projects. Making action video games tend to be the best way. Ask Elon Musk. Games industry heavyweights tend to be Western developers and Japanese, Korean, and Chinese. I wouldn't doubt India's capabilities, but hope they're going in this direction. One thing I know is never to make assumptions about a country or people not being able to do something because ignorant stereotypes, e.g., Japan can't innovate, China can't innovate, etc., usually end up being proven wrong. So I hope that's not the case here, but that's the stereotype of Indian programmers in the West is this, quantity over quality. So I thought that was a fantastic comment by B199er. If you want to read the entire comment, I did leave out a few paragraphs there just for brevity, but if you want to read the entire one, go back to the video on Indian app developers. I'll leave a comment to it in the description and let him know what you think, because I thought it was really poignant. I mean, I've been thinking about it all morning. I happen to agree with that. I think most people get into the software industry are not that good, but I think that they all have the potential to be, but some of them just don't have the drive to be. Right? I've worked with the software industry for 20 years, and that's one of the problems I see. I tend to hang around, like when I was working in software teams, I tend to hang around people who are really good at what they do because they make you better at what you do, and you're constantly improving and thinking about these kind of things. And I love what he said about the 90-10 rule. So 90% of developers are 90 developers just suck. 10% are really good. It's a problem I deal with on a constant basis, right? I'm trying to find really good developers to work with, you know, always being in that situation where we got client projects going on. And it's happened more than once where, you know, I've given something to somebody and it's just, they're not progressing. They're not getting there. Even when it comes to simple things like, I just need you to put a button here. I just need to do something like that. So a lot of the times I'm working on that core bit, which is the where API integration or actually being able to, you know, validation, that kind of stuff, and giving it to somebody else, and then I just watch them run the clock out on me to where I have to take it back and work on it myself. But I do think that anybody can become a great developer, but it's a constant, you have to constantly evolve that skill, right? I would like, when it comes to that 90-10 rule and the 1% being the elite, the ones that are actually worth something, I wish I could say I was in the 1%. I mean, maybe hopefully I'm in the 10%, but it is definitely something to think about. One of the things that, I mean, when I talk about the differences between a good developer and a bad developer, people are really shocked. They think, well, a bad developer might, you know, it might take twice as long to do something or three times as long. But, you know, there have been projects where I've given something to somebody else and I think, okay, I just need you to do this. I'll give you an example of something just recently. I brought on a new developer, and again, I don't want to drop, he was a nice guy, right? I don't want to like make a big deal of it, but it didn't work out. So basically it was like, I just want you to, this application, I want to connect to Firebase. So I wrote the logic to do the Firebase authentication and to connect to Firestore and write to Firestore. So I did all those kind of functions, just the basic mechanics. And I told him, I said, it's not pretty, but you know, you've got like, you know, plenty of time to work on it. And he did, he worked on it for 5 weeks. After 5 weeks, we hadn't really progressed anywhere. It was a lot of head scratching. There was a lot of, I can't figure out what it was. It was a lot of, I asked a question on Stack Overflow, whatever. And in the end, I took the project back, did the entire thing, like just in a week. I basically took everything he's done because there was a lot of, it was a bit messy. Take it and scrapped it and then did everything in 2 days. I mean, there were two long days. Don't get me wrong, but basically finished a project in 2 days as a 2 days opposed to 5 weeks. And you see this across the board. You'll give something to somebody, you will give something to a developer who's just, it's almost like a learned helplessness, right? And this is why being a software developer is hard. Being a software developer means you're constantly thinking, you're trying to find solutions to problems because code is never simple. I mean, sometimes it is. When it is, it's nice. When something just works, but more often than not, you're dealing with some sort of dependency issue, you're dealing with some sort of network issue, you've got something where you got, you know, something isn't installed right, something isn't working right on a certain machine, and it's just dig, and spending a lot of time finding that kind of stuff out. And that's, a lot of being a software developer is a slog and just pushing forward. And every time you push forward into a new field and a new thing, you get better at it. And the better you get at it, it gets frustrating because it's hard to find other people to help you out. Those are just my thoughts for today. I thought it was a really good comment. You guys might totally disagree with me. You might think I have my head up my own bum, but when did I start saying bum? I've been in England too long. You may think I have my head up my own butt, but I don't know. It's just what I think. I do think it's really, really, really hard to find good software developers. I mean, it's really hard to find excellent software developers. They're out there. But you have to turn over a lot of rocks to find them. Anyway, let me know what you guys think. Do you agree? Do you disagree? Thank you very much, B199er. Oh my God, I'm writing this down without looking at it. That was an excellent comment. I really appreciate that. Anyway, Hope you guys are having a fantastic day. That is it for today. I'll talk to you next time.